Mr. Hinn, can I get your full name and date of birth for the record, please?
And Joseph John.
A former Phoenix priest accused of sexually abusing young boys on the run overseas for more than a decade. Now he's back behind bars in the Valley, his victims anxious for justice that's been a long time in coming.
No one, not one, even to today, these many years afterwards, no one from the church has come down and interviewed me. What happened? They don't want to know.
We are hearing for the first time from a Phoenix man who says this former priest abused him sexually when he was an altar boy back in the late 1970s and early 80s.
You know, we have talked quite a bit lately about the new state law extending the statute of limitations for child sex crimes victims. This is a criminal case that has just been waiting to go to trial since Joseph Hinn skipped town 16 years ago. Then he escaped house arrest before he was finally rearrested in Italy 3 weeks ago.
The saddest thing about the story is how the church pushed me aside.
This man, now a Valley High School teacher, asked us to protect his identity as he prepares to testify at trial.
I'm not showing my face because not everybody can deal with that. And there's going to be those people in that group that says, hey, you know, watch out for this guy.
The innocence of his youth shattered when he says Father Joe Hinn sexually abused him repeatedly from 5th to 7th grade at St. Mark's Catholic School in Phoenix.
Did it cross your mind to confide in someone else?
The whole time.
Hinn worked at St. Mark's from 1978 to 82, teaching sex ed.
This priest, and I'm assuming the other ones follow the same model, get the kids at that certain age when they're going through their puberty. Got me during that age. I'm kind of understanding my own sexuality.
He says it started on a camping trip.
He was like a big brother.
His sleeping bag went missing and Father Joe had him share his.
I froze when it first happened.
He says there were showers, massages, trips to Disneyland. And he knew he wasn't the only one.
One victim told me that another priest approached and said, hey, I hear you give good back massages.
When the first boy came forward early on, he buried those memories and didn't tell a soul.
I shut it down. I'm like, I'm done. I'm not talking about this. Oh, nope.
Until a near-death car crash in 1991 jolted those memories loose.
This was in my mind back there, and I had to deal with it.
When he went to the church for help, they reported, not to police, but up their chain of command to the Phoenix diocese that he says rushed him to settle out of court.
I feel more abandoned from them and how they treated this than what Father Joe had done to me. It's the others that protected him and let it go by. They're almost as guilty as he is.
He still remembers the face-to-face sit-down with Father Joe before he signed.
And I did ask him about other victims. He said I was the only one, and I knew that was a lie. And they shut me down right away. The head priest of the order stepped in and said, he's not that far along in his therapy, so we'll talk about this later.
It makes me feel bad, terrible, awful. Something has to be done.
Tom Milady used to teach at St. Mark's with Father Joe and says the breach of trust makes him sick to his stomach and disappointed in the church.
What is the appropriate justice for someone accused of these crimes, do you think?
I would say life imprisonment. No possibility of parole, nothing. You've missed a number of lives, and now you're going to get what's coming to you.
It doesn't matter who you are. It doesn't matter what position you're in. It doesn't matter what title you have. If you harm a child in this county, we will hold you accountable.
Maricopa County Attorney Bill Montgomery says this case was always on his radar.
At one point, he was in custody.
Hinn was under house arrest in 2006 at the headquarters of his religious order in the Vatican, which did not compel him to return to the States to face charges. He reportedly escaped when the Italian High Court upheld the county extradition for 13 felony charges for abusing three young boys. And they honored that when Hinn got caught May 28th, now 70 years old, trying to use an expired passport in Italy.
Mr. Hinn, can I get your full name and date of birth for the record, please?
And Joseph John.
The Phoenix Catholic Diocese says Hinn was removed from ministry for sexual misconduct with a minor.
And your date of birth, sir?
March 17th, 1949.
They released this statement saying, Great efforts have been made to put systems in place to keep our young people safe, and we will work with law enforcement to uphold the principles of accountability and justice.
Ma tutti I carismi ci sono affidati.
Last month's National Conference of Catholic Bishops set up a new abuse reporting system, encouraging but not requiring church leaders to work with law enforcement.
It's an abuse of power.
Mary O'Day is a survivor who runs the local support group for SNAP, or the Survivors Network of Those Abused by Priests.
They're afraid to share their story, or afraid to come forward, and they don't get the help and the healing they need.
They are asking the Arizona Attorney General to join 20 other AGs and launch a new statewide investigation.
My prayers still go out to this priest.
More than forgiving Father Joseph Henn, this survivor feels sorry for him.
Well, he abused me. I feel sorry for him. And just to be living with this guilt and all the stuff he's done, it'd be so much easier if he just came out and said, hey, please forgive me.
Desperate for healing, he found peace in forgiveness and is looking forward to closure in justice.
Well, he has to face his consequences. If he'd stop running around, hiding, and just said he's sorry to everybody he's hurt and moved on, and whatever happens, happens, that's the way it should be held. The church, they're afraid of that.
County Prosecutor Rachel Mitchell, by the way, filed the original case against Henn 16 years ago. So imagine this man's surprise when he got a personal text message from her saying that there had finally been an arrest after all these years.